SMT Nation, welcome back to the channel. We're glad to have you for this episode. And what we're going to be talking about is T-Mobile's most recent fine. All right, so they had a breach a few months ago, and that was a pretty big deal. This one actually stems back, oh man, I can't believe it. It's been like a year and a half. All right, so this happened in June of 2020. For those of you that don't remember, it was a huge, massive outage across the country that affected a lot of regions. So let's take a look at this story. This is actually a follow-up from the FCC. They are going to fine T-Mobile almost $20 million for a 911 outage that occurred on June 15th, 2020. The outage lasted for 12 hours, a little bit over 12 hours, and it was over their 2G, 3G, and 4G networks created issues. A lot of calls were failing. It said here the outage caused more than 23,000 calls to go to 911 special facilities without location data, more than 20,000 calls to special facilities without callback information. So the FCC rules require that providers like T-Mobile, AT&T, and Verizon, if the outage lasts longer than 30 minutes, they have to report this so that way that a lot of these calls can start to get rerouted. So it looks to me like this is another fatal flaw of T-Mobile's, which appears to be negligence. This was a similar incompetency that we saw happen with the data breach. A lack of attention to detail, a lack of addressing and responding to these problems in a timely manner. So the inability to respond to thousands of potentially affected special facilities appears to be why this is such a large fine here. The cause of the failure is reported that it was a leased fiber transport link that failed on the T-Mobile network, and then there was a routing flaw as well. But again, that's not why they're getting fined here. They're getting fined because of their lack or inability to respond. So their response was the failure. Again, this is a recurring theme, a 12-hour outage. You know, after that 30-minute span, it looks like you're supposed to follow the protocol, and they didn't. So, you know, the networks do have outages. That's not really the issue here. Like Verizon has outages, AT&T has outages. We've seen failures happen. And then the right people get contacted and the right protocols can be followed. It looks here like this is pretty much incompetence and the inability to have the safeguards in place to respond to such events. So I'm not really surprised by the fine. I think the fine was justified and I think it was expected, and why it was levied makes a lot of sense. So this is just a follow-up. All right. Let me know what you guys think of the fine. Let me know if you think it's hefty enough. Me personally, I don't think that's anything. That's not really, no company's going to feel this. Not a, you know, a three carrier business, enterprise, consumer, you know, like this is a huge conglomerate. They have over 100 million customers. What's $19.5 million? That's two drops in a bucket, or as I like to say, two farts in the wind. All right. It's just not a bad fine. This is nothing. This is just the cost of doing business. But what say you? Sound off in the comment section below. You all, the voice of the people, the SMT Nation, let your voice be heard. Let me know what you think about the extent of the outage. If the fine is adequate, you think it should have been more harsh? Do you think it was too harsh? What do you think about the reasoning? You know, just go ahead and sound off. And if you appreciated this update, give this video a like and then share it to your socials. Subscribe for more content. Turn on the bell notifications. Check out the links in the description box, the Patreon page, if you want early access to videos, more exclusive content, podcast live streams, discounts on Los Mobile. You can support us there. And then my Twitter handle and the email address is located in the description box as well. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Peace.